unfamiliar to me. Publicly performing was very much encouraged. Like, even if you weren't particularly good at it or anything, you'd get be encouraged to get up there and just try your best. At parties, people would just bring a plate of food, they'd sing along. I was really privileged to have a background in a different culture of music. Growing up in our household, our parents weren't professional, like, musicians or anything like that. They did love music, they celebrated music. I remember when I was 5, every Saturday morning, Dad would crank up the stereo and he'd put in this disco DVD and Frank Sinatra. And my fondest memory growing up was, about 6 or 7, and we were at a kind of a flea market kind of thing, and there was a little baby toy piano, and I don't know why there were so many dolls, and I was really into dolls when I was little, and there were so many dolls, but I seemed to pick the baby toy piano. Growing up, we didn't have that much. We didn't get the privilege of having all these fancy new toys. So that's where our creativity got in. We made the most of what we had. Mum doesn't like have a classical music background, but for some reason she knew how to read. She knew, because I thought that was pretty amazing. I didn't know how she knew, but for some reason she kind of knew how to. So she taught me how to match the notes on the grand scale. My first kind of instrument was a plastic toy guitar. The strings were plastic. The sound was for me, I absolutely loved it. I probably slept with it every night. I was overly attached to it. Like, you couldn't separate her from it. And if we were fighting anything, I'd use it as language and be like, I'll take away your guitar. That was probably why I lost all the fights, because that guitar meant so much to me. But her first official keyboard was from a garage sale, and it played perfectly well until I put my foot on it. If I had to describe Rose in 4 words, she is headstrong, she's independent, reserved, just a little more laid back. I don't know the meaning of chill, but I think once you get to know, like, she can seem really closed off at the start, but once you get to know her, like, you try to, I feel like you'll realise how much of an amazing person she is. It's just a matter of breaking down those walls. Grace, I would describe her. She's caring. She's got a massive, massive heart. I guess she's a little bit scary. We're actually quite the opposite when it comes to deadlines and things. I guess I'm a little bit calmer. Passionate, and she's understanding. She definitely understands other people a lot. Like, it doesn't matter what circumstance you're in, she does understand, she does take time to understand. About her guitar, I think a lot of people need to start putting themselves in other people's perspective. It's so easy to get lost in this whole world, this little bubble of yours, that you kind of forget to step out of that little bubble and see that there's other things going on in this world besides, you know, you. I think sometimes her big heart is too big for her own good. She seems to want to see the best in people, but she forgets to look after herself a little bit. Oh my god, a lot of people